bad day of fishing beats a good day of anything else.
It's a nice
one,
whatever it is. It's putting up a heck of a plate. It's a pickerel. Oh, shook right off. Good. Don't have to get my hands slimy. Hey, everybody. This is Tony Page, the Fishing Fanatic. Well, I'm coming at you once again from my favorite little crappie honey hole, little pond here in southern New Hampshire that I had really, really good luck here last year. It's early morning. It is Memorial Day 2020 during the whole coronavirus stuff going on. Social distancing. I'm out here all by myself, so hopefully I get some good action. I've been out about 10 minutes and had one little pickerel kind of hit the line, and he shook right off, but that's good. I didn't have to get my hands dirty, so hopefully I'm chasing crappie, bluegill, panfish mainly. Might try to cast around for a little bit of bass, see what I come up with, so stay tuned. Another hit on the yellow rod here. That's what I'm targeting. Come on, buddy. All right. A good 10, 11 inches. Nice little fish. Got one on the yellow rod over here. So I'm running just a little spinner, the soft plastic, little curly tail worm type thing on it. Got one on the silver and green rod now. Let's see what we got here. Another crappie, that's a nice one. He's about a 12 inch one. All right, there you go, buddy. Let's go see if I can catch some more. Oh, got a hit on the yellow rod. Up a good fight. I don't know if it's another pickerel or not. And it is. Come here, you slimy little booger. Yeah, he's got the... Oh, alright, there he goes. Good. Didn't have to get my hands dirty again. Step back out there, see if we can get another one. Well, got one hooked up on this rod. Oh, shook off. Thank you. switched up my lure. I put a little segmented swim bait on this one. Had it out there a couple of minutes, and I got a fish. It's right up at the surface. Looks like it's probably a crappie. Maybe 9 or 10 inches. And here's a little segmented swim bait that I'm talking about. When that thing gets in the water, it swims. It'll look just like a real fish. It's pretty good. Alrighty, so we'll try to get another one. Got something on the yellow rod over here. Right up to the surface, looks like it's another crappie. Probably not a huge one, but that looks pretty nice. They're all good. Little fish. Back you go. Alright, got one over here on the yellow rod. Little guy, but as I've always said, worst fish I ever caught was fantastic. Got another one on the little segmented swim bait. Let's see what we got here. Surfing right up on top. Like another crappie. Looks like it might be a nice one too. Yeah, not bad. Probably a good 10, 11, 12 incher maybe. Hand span is about 10 inches, so yeah, he's probably close to 12. There you go. Catch him another time. Segmented swim bait here. Don't want to get that hook in my thumb. There he goes. Another one on the green rod here. Thank you. crappie, pretty nice one. Another 11, 12 incher. Bluegill, first one of the day. Oh, yeah, he's a tiny guy. Another crappie. I see him surfing up on the top. A lot of times the bluegills will dive deep. Pickerel will stay deep usually. Crappies, they just kind of come right up to the top. Since they're kind of flat, they just surf right along. He goes. He just shook off. I'm trying a little different tactic on these guys. Stop trolling for a little bit. I put a little tungsten jig head and a soft plastic. Similar to what I'd use for ice fishing, and trolling around, marking some fish on my Garmin Panoptics Live Scope. I don't know if you can see that screen or not. Shows almost a three, not really a 3D image, but it's a pretty darn good image. And I troll around, I mark some fish, drop my jig down. I just had one come over and hit it, spit it out. And I see some other fish up a little bit higher. Reel up a little bit, maybe they'll come back for it. Yep, here he comes. I can see him swimming right across for it. He's only about 4 feet down. He's right on it. See if he hits it. Well, he's interested. He swims away and then he comes back. Swims away, comes back. He's just down below it right now, which is telling me it's probably a crappie, because crappie will usually hit from below. Their eyes are kind of situated a little more on top of their head. They look up at the bait when they hit it. Oh God, something just tapped it.
Songs that transport you back.
Could be a bluegill too.
Memories that last forever. From tracks that make up SiriusXM's classic rock.
I think whatever it is went away. I don't see him on the screen anymore. Side of the screen, started coming towards it, now he went away. Just like the song on the radio is saying, who are you? Come on. There, I got one. Look at that. Jigged up another nice crappie. How about that? There you go. Go tell your buddies there's lunch over here. Have them come and get some more. All right, so that's what I'm using. Look, I don't know if you can see on the screen. Oh, he was just swimming away. All right. I think that's going to be a wrap for today. Had a pretty good day out here. I've been out here about 3 hours. I don't even know how many fish I caught. 16, 18, 20 maybe, something like that. Mostly crappie, which is what I was targeting. Got a couple of slimy little pickerels. Got one bluegill. That was about it. never did get around to doing some bass fishing. Time's running out on me today. I got some stuff to do this afternoon. So until next time, see ya.
Bet you're going fishing all of the time. Baby going fishing too. Bet your life, your sweet wife, will catch more fish than you. Many fish bites if you got good bait. Here's a little tip that I would like to relate. Many fish bites if you got good bait. I'm a going fishing, yes, I'm going fishing, and my baby going fishing too.